Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Mubi here again with another video. In today's video, it's going to be a tutorial on how to make this very lovely top that I have on. It's a halter neck top and yeah, it's very perfect for this season. It's kind of hot everywhere, so this outfit right here is going to be something very perfect for you or your daughter or for your sister, anybody around you that you feel like, you know, making this kind of outfit for, or your clients, right? You might have people coming to your business and asking you to make something like this. So this tutorial is supposed to help you know how to make this for yourself or for someone. So if you've been interested in learning all about that, please be sure to watch this video to the end. Also, don't forget to give it a big fat thumbs up and subscribe if you're yet to subscribe and all that good stuff. All right, guys, don't let me talk too much. Let's get straight into the tutorial. Let's go.
Alright guys, so I'm going to start off by showing you what you need. You need your fabric. For me, I'm using this raw silk fabric. You also need a paper for drawing your pattern. You need your scissors for cutting your pattern as well as your fabric. You also need a tape roll and a ruler for just marking measurements and drawing measurements and connecting lines to each other. You also need your marker or biro or pencil depending on what you choose. You also need your pins, of course, for holding your fabric together. So I'm going to start off by drawing my guideline, and my guideline is just where all my other measurements will just begin from. So my guideline is supposed to be like my shoulder line, and your measurements typically starts off from your shoulder. So that's the line I just drew right there with my biro. I hope you guys can see. Next up, I'm going to be marking my other measurements. I'm going to mark my bust measurements, and for me, my shoulder to my bust is about 11 inches. I'm going to go upwards by 2 inches, so I'll go ahead to mark 9 inches, and that line will be my armhole line. For all these terminologies that I'm, you know, stating here, I have another video prepared for you guys where I just explain them in details. So I'm marking the midpoint between my shoulder and my armhole line. So my armhole line from my shoulder is 9 inches, so the midpoint is about 4.5 inches. I went ahead to mark that line, and that line is typically called your chest line. So that's where I just marked upwards there. Now I'm marking the length of my outfit, because for this particular tutorial, the waist measurement doesn't really matter because the outfit is kind of free at the waistline. So it's not necessary to mark your waistline, but if you just want to be precise and all of that, you can still mark your waist measurements, even though that measurement is not going to your waistline now, even though that line is not really going to count as we go along. So all I'm doing now is I'm just marking those lines. I've marked my shoulder line, my chest line, my armhole line. Now I'm marking my bust line. Next up, I'm marking my waist. I went ahead to draw my waistline, even though that line is not going to count, and we're going to see as we go along. Next, I'm going to mark my dress length, or my top length. Now for this top, I decided to go with about 26 inches. I didn't want it to be jumping so I marked 23 inches at first, but later I went on to add some inches to it just to make it very, very, you know, long, to cover everywhere basically. Next up, I'm going to be marking my shoulder measurement. My shoulder measurement, half of it is 8 inches. Next up, at the armhole line and the bust line, I'm going to mark quarter of my bust measurement and add 1 inch to it, and that's going to give me about 11 inches. My round bust is 40 inches, and then I added 1 extra inch just to give me ease at that point. So I'm marking that exact same measurement on my armhole line and my bust line. The next line I'm going to be working on is going to be my top length line, and that's the last line right there. I'm going to mark quarter of my hip measurement, and then I added about 2 inches to give me ease, just to allow the top to be free at the bottom. Next up, I'm drawing my armhole curve, connecting the points I marked as my shoulder point to the points I marked on my armhole line, and that's what I'm just using my armhole curve for right there. Next up, I'm going to draw a slanting line just to give me the flared effect that I'm going for with my top, and I'm using my straight ruler to just draw that line right there. The next thing I want to do now is basically work on the neckline of my top. For the neckline, I'm working with 3.5 inches by 1 inch, and then I'm just using my armhole curve right there just to draw the curve to give me my neckline. And then I'm also going to go down by 1 inch at that my armhole line right there. I'm going to come down by 1 inch, mark it, and then draw a slanting line connecting the neckline point to that armhole point. Next up, I'm going to draw a straight line just to square out that point, and that is where I'm going to now mark the measurement for my halter neck. So the center front, for the front piece now that I'm working on, I'm going to mark about 5.5 inches on that new line that I drew. I'm drawing again with this my navy blue marker so you guys get to see what I'm doing clearly. So on that navy blue line, I'm going to mark about 5.5 inches, and then I'm going to go ahead to draw my new armhole curve, and this is what we have here. The next thing I'm going to do now is to make my top a bit longer. I just felt like this length that I'm working with is going to be a bit too short, and this is what we have now. This is my pattern for my top. I also went ahead to mark my allowances now. So at the top of my blouse, right, I marked about 2 inches allowance. I'm adding 2 extra inches when I cut on fabric, and at the sides, every other place, the seam, the side seams, the armhole seam and all of that, I'm going to add about 1/2 inch to those points, just to serve as allowance for turning the armhole points and turning the hem of my top, basically. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to place this pattern on my fabric, and then before I go ahead to cut, I'm going to mark all the allowances that I wrote on my paper. Like I said, at the top of your front piece, you're going to mark about 2.5 inches, just to serve as the hole for you to pass the piece of rope that is going to serve as your rope for your halter neck top, right? And then at the side seams and all of that, I'm working with 1/2 inch. Feel free to make it 1 inch if that's what you like, but for me, I'm working with 1/2 inch, and at the top, I'm working with 2 inches. So once I'm done marking those dimensions, I'm going to go ahead to cut my fabric, and that's exactly what I'm doing right here, taking my time to cut my top. If you've made it up to this point and you're yet to be subscribed to my channel, hey there, I do videos like this. My name is Fumibe. First of all, I do videos like this all the time on my channel, where I just share how to make beautiful pieces of items for yourself, a blouse, a dress, a headpiece. I just do a bunch of different things on here. I like to do stuff with my hands, and I like to share those things that I make with my hands. I like to share tutorials on them on here on YouTube. So if my content looks like something you'll be interested in subscribing to, please do well to hit the subscribe button and join me on here. Also, if you watch any of my videos, please be sure to hit the like button so I know that you thoroughly enjoyed watching any one of my tutorials. So once I'm done cutting this front piece, this piece that is going to serve as the front piece of my top, I'm going to go ahead to use this exact same piece to cut the back of my top. Because I was working with a fabric that has pretty bold prints, I made sure that I was cutting such that the prints kind of align with each other. If you're using a fabric that has like tiny prints, or just, I don't know how to put it now, if you have a fabric that has like tiny pieces of patterns on it, it's always very easy to cut those types of fabric. But once you're working with fabrics like this that have bold prints, you need to be sure that you're cutting such that the prints kind of align. You don't want to cut your fabric in such a way that the prints do not align. So for me, it was kind of difficult, but I found a way around it to make sure that the front of my top looks like the back of my top. And that's exactly what I'm doing here. I had to turn the fabric upside down to get another piece, like another section of my fabric that was going to resemble the front piece. And that's exactly what I'm doing there, using the front piece as a guideline for cutting the back piece. All right guys, so once I was done cutting, I went ahead to just mark about 2 inches at the edge of this front and back piece, and then I'm going to draw a curve so that the edge of my blouse doesn't look too sharp when I wear it on myself, just to give it like a nice curve at the edge. That was what I did there. Once I was done marking it, I went ahead to just cut it off to just give me a nice curve at the side seam of my top, and that's exactly what I'm doing here. Once I'm done doing this, we are now going to start with sewing. So first of all, I'm going to take these two pieces, the front and back piece, I'm going to take it to my sewing machine and use a zigzag stitch just to kind of weave the edge of my fabric. So it's called weaving, right? And then for the back piece, I'm going to open it up, right, and then go ahead to weave it as well using zigzag stitches on my sewing machine. If you have a serger, feel free to use your serger. If you have a weaving machine, feel free to do that, just to tidy up the edge of your fabric so that it doesn't start fraying. So now that I'm done doing all that, the first thing I'm going to do now is connect the two sides of my back piece. So I'm placing them on each other, right side facing each other, and then I'm pinning it together. Like I said, working with silk, you have to pin just to make sure that your fabric stays put. And then I'm going to go ahead to mark about 7 inches. I'm going to, from the top, mark 7 inches just to serve as opening for my top to pass through my head when I want to wear it. And from that point, I'm going to just sew a seam line right at that point, and I'm working with 1/2 inch, and I'm marking that sewing allowance right there on this piece of fabric. Once I'm done marking that 1/2 inch, I'm going to take it to my sewing machine and then just connect the two sides together. And this is what we have here. I'm going to go ahead to work on the side seam of my top. I'm going to place the front piece and the back piece on each other, right sides facing each other. And I'm also going to go ahead to mark the side seam allowance of 1/2 inch. And I'm going to sew the two sides of my fabric together to give me one single piece. Once that is done, I'm going to work on tidying up the neckline of the back piece, that point there, that 7 inch point allowance that we did there. I went ahead to use my hemming gum just to tidy up the neckline so it looks very, very nice and smooth. This is what a hemming glue looks like. It's typically kind of light, and that's just how it looks. And this is what my neckline now looks like. I pressed it on. You typically need an iron. You need to iron it onto whatever surface you're trying to use it to work on. And then once I was done doing that, I went ahead to just sew the side seams of my top, and this is what we have right here. Once that is done, the next thing I want to do is basically work on tidying up the hem of my top, and I went ahead to just fold it twice on half of an inch, and then that's what we have right there. The next thing we want to do now is turn the neckline of this particular top using a piece of bias. In my last tutorial on how to make a shift dress, I already shared how to use a bias with you guys in that particular video. So if you want to learn in detail, please feel free to go check out that video. This is what my armhole now looks like. The next thing we are going to work on is the hole or the piped part of this our top that is going to serve as the space for our rope to go through. So that's what I'm marking now. I'm marking the 2-inch allowance that we marked at the beginning of the video, if you guys remember when I was marking that dimension on my fabric when I was cutting on a pattern. So once I was done marking that 2-inch, I'm going to fold over my fabric up until that 2-inch mark and then go ahead to sew, just to serve as a piped hole for the rope that is going to go through that part of this particular top. And what I'm doing here is just using my pin to secure my fold so that it stays put when I go to my sewing machine to just sew that particular portion. And I'm also going to repeat the same thing on the back piece of this top. Fold over up until that 2-inch mark and then go to my sewing machine and then sew as carefully as possible. You are sewing as close to the edge of that piped part of your top as possible. You are sewing very, very close. Make sure your sewing is very neat. Take your time, no rush. And then once you are done, we are going to come back to make our rope for this particular halter neck top. This is what the neckline now looks like once I was done sewing. Look at how beautiful it looks. It looks very neat, right? I know. All right, guys. So the next thing now is for us to work on creating our rope for our halter neck top. So for this rope, you are working with, I just went ahead to fold a piece of fabric, no serious measurements, folded it over, and then I marked about 2 inches on that folded piece. I folded it over each other just to make cutting easy, and then once I was done, I marked 2 inches, and then I'm just going to go ahead to cut that, and it's just going to give me a very long piece of rope. You want the rope to be at least about 25 inches, 30 inches long, just so you get a very beautiful result at the end of the day. And this is what it looks like. What I'm going to do now is I'm just going to go ahead to pipe this piece of fabric, fold it over like this. I'm showing you guys how to pipe fabric a couple of times on here on my channel, but for those who are new, this is how to pipe a fabric. Just fold the edges together and then fold it again one more time. And then what I'm going to do now is take it to my sewing machine and then just sew as close to the edge of that piped section as possible. And this is what we have here. This is the rope that we are going to be working with for this particular top. What I'm going to do now is I'm just going to pass this my long rope through the hole that I already sewed and created on my top. And yeah guys, that's pretty much it for this particular tutorial. Making a halter neck top is very, very easy, straight to the point. The only stress I had to go through was because of the texture of this my fabric. With silk, it moves around a lot, so with sewing you have to be very precise. But if you're using another type of fabric, sewing is going to be easy peasy. Making this top is so easy, and you can make it for your sister, you can make it as a present for your friend, you can make it for anybody really. So this is me now rocking my top. I feel absolutely beautiful in it. It's very perfect. I've worn it a couple of times ever since I made it. I made it like a few weeks ago and I've worn it a couple of times. It's so convenient and just easy. And for me, I love anything that exposes my shoulders. I'm sure you guys have noticed on here on my channel, so it's one of my favorite pieces of clothing items right now. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to give me a big fat thumbs up. Also, if you're yet to subscribe, please consider subscribing to my channel. I share a lot of useful tutorials like this on here. And yeah guys, thank you so much for watching. I really, really appreciate every single one of you, and I can't wait to see you guys in my next tutorial. Love and appreciate you. Bye. Mwah.